We often consider the type of food we eat and crave part of who we are, or at the very least, part of what we like. You may consider yourself a chocolate lover, a cereal person, or someone that cannot live without eating a good filet mignon once a week. But how would you feel if the cravings or the feeling of fullness and satisfaction we get after a meal are being manipulated by small organisms living inside our body?
Yummy.
There are approximately 40 trillion bacteria in our bodies. Most of them live in the large intestine. And to put this number into perspective, we only have around 30 trillion cells that make up our bodies. And when you think about it, having that many bacteria living inside our bodies and depending on the food we eat, it is not that far-fetched of an idea that they have figured how to communicate and tell our bodies what they want to eat, making us think we came up with the idea of eating that chocolate bar. Gut bacteria doesn't only make us crave the type of food containing the nutrients they need, but they can also change the flavor of the food we eat, making it tastier. They can make us feel good after eating certain dishes, and even induce the feeling of fullness or satiety after absorbing the nutrients they needed. Bacteria can control our feeding behavior through a variety of mechanisms. For example, scientists found that after E. coli finishes absorbing the nutrients they need, they can activate brain regions that reduce appetite. I feel full already. This is very interesting because, like many other bacteria, E. coli is found in our gut, not our brain, but it is still able to activate brain regions involved with the feeling of fullness. It achieves this by producing CLPB. This E. coli protein is able to act as one of our own hormones and trick our body into initiating this molecular pathway for suppressing our appetite. First, CLPB attaches and activates a receptor in our gut that increases the levels of at least two of our own satiety hormones. These hormones will then activate neurons in our vagus nerve, which signals the brain to activate the neural circuits involved with suppressing our appetite. The process happens around 20 minutes after having a meal, which, funny enough, is how long it usually takes us to feel full. So sometimes, it may not be that you're actually full and that you can't eat anymore, but that bacteria inside your body are. And this was one example of how gut bacteria can control our feeding behavior. But, as mentioned before, their control doesn't stop there. No. Bacteria in our tongue can make food tastier by producing food odor from odorless components. They will basically transform some molecules that have no smell or taste into molecules that do, increasing the flavor of what we eat. They can also increase or alter taste receptors in our tongue, changing the taste of the food we eat. Other bacteria living further down our gut may produce chemicals that will make us feel good when we eat something they like, and could even hijack some of the 100 million neurons we have in our digestive tract. These neurons are part of the vagus nerve, which will then tell our brain what the bacteria wants, which we feel as cravings. So it seems like they are pretty much in control of our feeding behavior, right? And this is a real problem because we may be craving and eating food that is harmful to our bodies. But here is what we do have working in our favor. While the bacteria living in our gut seems to be able to control many of our feeding behavior, we are still in charge of which bacteria get to live in our bodies. Different species of bacteria will prefer different types of nutrients. Some may like sugar, while others prefer fat or fiber. By changing our diet, we can starve some bacteria and introduce other types of bacteria that will help us live healthier lives. For example, we can stop eating foods that contain too much sugar to starve some bacteria. Or we can take prebiotics and probiotics to introduce healthy bacteria into our gut. Yogurts with no added sugar, kombucha, kimchi, and other fermented foods are a good start if you would like to introduce healthy bacteria into your gut. Eating fruits, vegetables, red wine, dark chocolate, and coffee also help to increase the diversity of bacteria species in our gut, which is important to have all the different bacteria needed to break down food, neutralize toxins, and make nutrients we need, We can also use antibiotics to kill species that are considered bad bacteria or even have fecal transplants. This is a real thing, where stool from a person with healthy bacteria is transferred into someone else's gastrointestinal tract. As we change our diet and get rid of unhealthy bacteria, cravings for unhealthy food should decrease. So give probiotics and fermented food a try, and let me know if your cravings change.